Hi guys, welcome to Easy Peasy Gardening. My name is Ruchi and today we are going to sow some kale seeds. Kale is a hardy cool season green that is part of the cabbage family. It can be used in salads and soups and curries. It is really healthy as it is rich in minerals and in vitamin A and C. It has big frilly leaves that really look beautiful. It can be planted in spring or in summer, but the best time to plant is in late summer so that they can be harvested in fall. In winters, you may want to mulch the soil to protect them and they will keep on producing fresh leaves. They grow best in full sun, but enrich the soil with compost before transplanting the seedlings. And when harvesting, don't pick the middle leaves because that's where the new growth happens. So just keep on picking the leaves from the side. And if they are tough, you can use them in curries or use them as you use spinach. And the tender leaves can be used in salads and sandwiches. So this is what we are going to sow today. So I have this seed planter which has 6 pods in it. So this is really a great way for planting the seeds, because when they grow up, and if you want to just take out a few of the plants without disturbing the other plants, you can just take out the plants from one pot. So I'm going to, I have put some good potting soil in that. I'm taking out the seeds, and what I'll try to do is that I'll try to put like 3 or 4 seeds in each pod. Because you can never be sure of germination, maybe only one seed will grow. So just to, as a backup, I'll put 3 to 4 seeds in each pod. And that way, even if there is 50% germination, I'll have some plants in each of these pods. Okay. Some of them have more seeds, but that's fine. Okay, so now I'm going to cover it with more soil so that the seeds are moist and warm. And for a few days till the time they germinate, this planter actually doesn't need any sunlight, so you can put it anywhere you want. So I keep my planters wrapped up in a plastic bag like this, and I put it on the windowsill where it gets about 2-3 hours of sunlight. So what happens is that the moisture of the soil gets evaporated and then it condenses back into the soil. As you can see on the plastic bag, there are water droplets because of the condensation. So basically this process helps in keeping the moisture and the warmth inside, and that helps in the germination. So that's what I did to my kale seeds, and after a week this is what happened. In every pod there are 3-4 seedlings and they are doing pretty well. So about 12 days have passed now from the time we planted these seeds, and the kale plants are looking strong and healthy. Now we have put them in an area where they get 2-3 hours of morning sun. So they are doing pretty well. So about 2 weeks have passed and you can see that there are many more kale seedlings that have come up. And some of them even have the third leaf. So it's doing pretty well now. So we'll wait for another 2 weeks and then we'll check on them, and maybe at that time they'll be ready for transplant. So our kale is 3 weeks old now. As you can see, now they have developed true leaves.
So if we look at one of the plants, let's take a look at this one. So it has first two leaves, those round leaves, which are not really true leaves. They are the seed leaves which provide nourishment in the beginning. And then these two are the true leaves which have started photosynthesis, and now these two leaves are basically supporting this plant. So whenever you have at least four leaves in a seedling, then it is ready for transplantation. So we are going to transplant this today to a bigger planter. So here I have a planter which has drainage at the bottom, and then I have filled it with a good potting soil mix. You have to just gently take them out and not disturb them too much, and then just transplant them. So just flip over the container and gently squeeze out the pod. I'm trying to take out this pod. So from the back, you know, gently push it. So see here, it has come out a little bit. So I'm just pushing it from the back. And it has come out. And you can see the roots. So now, because it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 plants, we have to separate them out. So let's do it slowly. So here I've got a plant. So in this big planter, I'll make a hole. So that this whole thing just fits in there. Put this whole soil with the plant in here and just fill it up. Add more soil as required. And gently press it down around it so that, you know, it gets the support of the soil. And that's good. And then water it, because you know the plant got a shock, so you just want to make sure that, you know, it is properly hydrated. And now we have to put it in a shaded area, maybe for a couple of days, and then once you feel that, you know, it is doing okay, then just move it out in the sun. So we'll see how it is progressing in about 1 week, and go from there. So our kale in the planter started to grow and became bigger, but unfortunately after some time it died. I think the planter was just too small for it. But the good thing was that we also planted a few plants in the ground, and they did really well. So we planted some of the kale plants in the ground, and when the weather was warm, they were not growing as much. But as soon as the fall approached, you know, the kale started to really grow very fast. And look at it now. You know, we can just harvest it from the sides, the big leaves, and it just keeps on growing. So I hope this video was useful to you. If you have any questions, leave a comment and I'll try to answer as soon as possible. If you like this video, press the like button and subscribe to our channel. And I'll see you next time. Happy gardening. Bye.